I think compositing in Blender is one of the most underrated tools. Most artists have only heard about compositing and do not care about how it can be used, while compositing can not only simplify the work on 3D art or animation, but can help to automate the working process. Compositing in Blender is a part of general pipeline that we can see when we open the program. This means that its use can go beyond simple combining materials into a single picture, and let's see if the Blender compositing can be used, for example, instead of Photoshop or DaVinci Resolve. In other words, what compositing in Blender can do and how can we use this tool as a digital artist. So, the most obvious way to using compositing in Blender is post-production and adding some post-effects. Despite the fact that the main goal of compositing is the merging of material into one image, there are such nodes as color balance, which can be used for color correction and color gradient. It's clear that deep color settings like in DaVinci Resolve are not here, but using color balance, we can also have the same settings like lift gamma gain, which means we can grade the whole picture as well as separately light and shadows. In general, compositing has all the basic color nodes, such as brightness, contrast, color correction, gamma, hue correct, and curves. And using all this in real-time compositor, we can adjust the color directly into the viewport. This is really stunning because it saves a lot of time. In order to try to achieve the right color tone in 3D scene using different light sources, I can open a compositor and add the right color with the help of color balance. In fact, it's post-production directly in Blender, and you will get the final art already with all effects like glare, lens distortion, and post-production layers without having to open a Photoshop. I'm using the new Blender 4.2, and in this version, developers have boosted the speed of compositing. Now compositing in Blender works much faster, and I would say it's pretty compared with speed of camera raw in Photoshop that I usually use for post-production of my artworks. Also, now we can choose between CPU and GPU for compositing as well as for rendering. And this takes compositing to the level where it can be used instead of Photoshop or DaVinci Resolve because it works really fast. If previously compositing in Blender could cause uncomfortable situation when working with large files, masks and effects, now you can see that I do color correction and everything is updated on the fly. With Blender 4.2, working in compositing has become enjoyable, and I have personally waited for this for a long time because I love compositing in Blender and I use it always in my work. It's easier for me to open up compositing here and do the necessary manipulation than to open a Photoshop. This is especially true when you need to make a lot of renders for catalogs or other purposes, no matter what. Here we get the point that by using compositing in Blender we can not only save time on the post-processing of the render, but also optimize working time by getting different options from one render without making the render again. For example, I have such simple scene with the furniture. And let's realize I need to get several different options with different colors for this chair. Using compositing, everything that I need is a CryptoMate that can be found and activated in render layers. Using CryptoMate in compositing, I can select absolutely any object in the scene and turn them into the mask for work. I have a detailed video how to use CryptoMate in Blender on my channel. Find the link in the corner of this video. So, using this CryptoMate and, for instance, the hue saturation node, I can easily select the different colors for this chair. Even copy the hue saturation node again and use the same CryptoMate to get the different colors. And I don't need to adjust the material of this chair itself and make a new render. As you can see, everything can be done very quickly using compositing in Blender. In fact, masks are the basic of compositing or post-production. No matter whether you use Photoshop for this or other software, if you want to be a pro artist, you definitely have to use masks for local editing or combining materials. That's why we need masks. Using compositing in Blender, we can easily create masks, except for already considering CryptoMate, which allows us to simply select objects as a mask. We can draw a mask or add standard one like circle or square and use them, for example, for color correction. At the same time, do this only in Blender. More detailed video how we can do this I upload on my Patreon, link in the description to this video. Alright, let's go ahead and look at more sophisticated task of how we can use compositing in Blender. Using compositing in Blender, we can work with depths, which means using this data and masks can easily add fog even without having to use volume fog in the 3D scene, which in some situation can save enough time on rendering. Volume has a big impact on the speed render as we know, but in compositing using Z-depths we can add this fog much faster as you can see. In general, compositing is about saving time. In fact, there is no need to render the whole complex frame simultaneously, especially if it's an animation. Let's say making correction and do render again for the whole animation will be quite problematic, considering that you may receive not only one or two comments on the project, and doing render again and again will take quite a lot of time. In this case, compositing is the best tool for solving this problem. So, now as a pro artist, we can separate the whole scene into layers and merge them into one image in compositing. And we come to how to maximize the use of compositing in Blender. Especially those who do not have a computer with the power of a nuclear reactor and want to make beautiful animations and renders. So, I have, for example, this scene. Despite the fact that the scene looks simple, there is a lot of fog, and the render of one 4K frame takes 15 minutes. It might be good for static render, but pretty long time for animation. Even that's not the point. Look at here. I've already separated the project into layers, and I've got the whole scene arranged into a group of objects that are stacked along the camera distance. In addition, there is a separate layer with water and fog itself. So, what I do next? Next, I can combine all the layers into one image like I would get it just rendering the whole scene. But in this case, I get a lot of benefits. First of all, it's less resources for rendering because I'm making a separate fog render layer which requires much power for rendering. Second is the local adjustments of each individual layer. So, I can add color correction and make it even warmer fog as well as do the same for other layers. In this case, using render layers and compositing, we give flexibility to our work. If you have a big project, maybe you are working on Avatar, where there are a lot of graphics and visual elements, then it's not appropriate to render it all in one layer. By splitting into different elements, you optimize the render time and you get flexibility in the final artwork. Also, as I mentioned before, when working with animation, may happen some situation when you spend 10 hours on rendering and you get some bugs or artifacts on the image. Do render again. I doubt that is a reasonable approach. In this case, compositing provides all the tools that can help us, something to fix, make correction, and without necessary to make render again. We come to the fact that compositing, this is a tool, can facilitate our work and in some situation even save the project. So, study the Blender Toolkit with me. Blender in this case is a very great option, free and friendly. It's clear that compositing in Blender has a little limited functionality compared to the monsters of the industry like Nuke, Fusion, but as we see, even this functionality is enough to certain tasks. Subscribe to my channel so you don't miss the new video. Also subscribe to my Patreon to unlock exclusive content, tutorials and masterclasses, as well as support my channel. So, see you in the next video.